My name is Tassos, and I'm with RF Elements. I'd like to thank all of you for attending our vendor presentation today. It's great to see all these faces. I remember our first vendor presentation 4 years ago when we first introduced our product, and I think we had like 6 people in the room or something like that. So it's great to see where things are going, and I appreciate you all for coming. So let's start. The number one problem for WISPs today is really noise, right? If we did a poll about 2 years ago and we gathered information from a bunch of WISPs, and we looked at what the top 10 issues were. And if you look at it, lack of spectrum was really the number one issue with ISPs today. RF noise was yet another issue. And then really the need to grow throughput, right? If you actually look at these three top problems for ISPs today, for wireless ISPs, they're really kind of all the same thing, right? They're all related. So the number one issue for WISPs is noise, and it's caused by RF pollution is really what it's all about. And RF pollution is caused, you know, by the endless number of noise that's created by all the equipment that's being deployed in the field today. And it's this kind of old technology, these old antenna technologies that people are using and still deploying, that's actually creating this noise, right? And it's compounding every day. You know, noise is really just the result of, you know, signals going outside of your coverage area in an area where you don't really want it to go, and also in unintended directions, right? So, you know, without the ability to control the propagation of your RF, this is where noise comes from. With that, I'd like to go into our vendor updates. So let's talk about new products, what I think most people are coming from. So again, we've kind of changed the industry when we first introduced our first symmetrical horns, and then, you know, ultra horn came after that. And so now we're addressing yet another issue, right? So we keep looking at, you know, the feedback that's coming from customers, and you know, we're trying to address all the issues with our technology our way. So without further ado, I'd like to introduce the asymmetrical horn twist port antenna. So we have three new antennas now. We have a 30 degree sector, a 60 degree sector, and a 90 degree sector with an asymmetrical beam pattern. So you get all the great beam performance that we had before with our symmetrical in an asymmetrical pattern. So now you get that more narrow vertical beam with wider horizontal beams with increased gain, right? So for those rural areas where, you know, you don't have the ability or you don't really have the user base in order to install multiple horns, you want less horns with more coverage, we have an asymmetrical beam pattern for that. So you still get the wideband beam performance as well, right? So as you start changing frequencies, the beam pattern is way more stable. So we're able to, again, give you the asymmetrical pattern that you've been looking for, more of the sector feel as far as beam pattern goes, but with all the benefits of noise isolation, absolutely no side lobes, and great performance. So we go from your traditional sector to now the RF pattern of an asymmetrical horn antenna. Again, just like all our antennas, they all have the same common interface, right? So they all have the same twist port mechanism. So no matter what radio or twist port adapter you're using with the symmetrical horns, you can go in between. So there's no change to that. So everything's the same. But it's a very unique design in how it's constructed and how it's put together. Again, we're using, you know, all rustless type metals, right? So aluminum, stainless steel, and high-grade plastics for all our builds, and the same stuff we've been using for a long time. The availability will be February of 2019, so that's right around the corner. Some might come to market a little bit sooner, but February 2019 is the delivery date that we're looking for all three models. So whether you need a 16 dB 90 degree horn compared to our previous 90 degree, which is only like 10 dB, so it's about 6 dB increase for the same width, it's quite impressive, or a 60 degree at 17 dB, so it's, again, you're getting way more gain now from a much wider beam, or a 20.5 dB 30 degree asymmetrical pattern. All three, again, will be available by February of 2019. Symmetrical horn carrier class Gen 2, right? So this is the same carrier class, but Generation 2 is now being released. They're actually available right now. So if you're looking for the Generation 2 carrier class horns, they're available. And we're making them available again in all the different sizes. So everything from 30 to 90 degree and the 10 degree steps will all be available. So let's talk about some of the Gen 2 improvements. So we get a lot of questions about the Gen 2. So Generation 2 had a lot of upgrades, more from the user experience thing. The bracket was easier, the radome was more robust, changing from left side of the pole to right side of the pole mounting is a lot easier with Gen 2. But the RF performance is actually improved as well. The biggest improvement you'll see is in the VSWR, right? So we have much better, much lower VSWR across the whole spectrum, which actually gives us better gain performance across the whole spectrum. And then again, we've changed the actual build, right, itself and how it's put together and how it assembles and how it's used. Gen 2 also has some ecological packaging, right? So no more styrofoam and other stuff in the boxes. We're also releasing now the carrier class for the Ultra Horn. So for all the customers out there that have been wanting to use, say, Mimosa B5C with our horn antenna, or you've been wanting to use the new Cambium PMP 550 series line, we now have a connectorized Ultra Horn for all those radios where the form factor doesn't suit having an actual adapter. So again, let's talk just a little bit about the noise isolation difference, right? So if we really compare a horn-based point-to-point antenna to a parabolic dish antenna, there's absolutely no comparison in the noise isolation that you get from it by having zero side lobes. So it's a really great improvement. And again, if we kind of compare what the pattern looks like between a parabolic dish and a horn, you can clearly see how much more uniform. And this uniformity is what translates into more stable connections and higher MCS rates. Our Ultra Horn is built like a tank. Again, really, really sturdy. It's an awfully large antenna, right? But again, the mounting system for it is very robust. And again, they're available now. Twist port adapter for ISO and prism stations are also available. This recently came out. It's been on the market for a little bit, but just an update. So we have an adapter if you want to convert the waveguide interface from a Ubiquiti radio to still use our horn antennas. And we have compatibility for all the ISO station, the prism station, as well as the LTU new form factor that they're coming out with. Twist port adapter for air fiber and prism. So this is again a new product that's already available on the market. And this is a single adapter that allows you to use either the prism radio or the air fiber radio all in one adapter. So you're able to have basically four. There's Gen 1, Gen 2 prism, and then you have air fiber 5X and the HD. So all four of those radios are perfectly compatible. And it really gives you the ability to kind of migrate and grow, right? You start with prism, then you might want to go to LTU. This one adapter will allow you to do that without having to change that. Twist port adapter for router board. This is the Gen 2 feed for anybody who's using Microtech. So this is the plastic enclosure for Microtech router boards. That's going to be available in January 2019. The twist port adapter for router board in metal. So a twist port adapter for router boards in all die cast aluminum. That's available now and at distributors. And it's really made for the M11G board, but you could also put 911s, 711s, 411s, all the different square form factor boards will actually work in that enclosure. And then finally, we have the connectorized twist port adapter. So the twist port adapter is, you know, for, again, the radio platforms that don't have a twist port adapter for, you can now use our connectorized twist port adapter in order to use all these other radio platforms. Also in the future, as we have different antennas, we may not make a carrier class antenna for every product that we have. So again, if you require using one of our antennas with a radio platform that there is no adapter for, we have the twist port adapter with SMA connectors on it now. So these should be available in December of 2018. So with that, you know, we hope to make 5 gigahertz great again and continue innovating our products and bringing new designs and new innovations to the industry. So thank you very much, everybody, for coming out. I appreciate you taking the time and hope to see you back at our booth and see this in person. Thank you.